Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about linear search. So for this video, you'll be learning on how to write pseudocode to search an array using linear search, as well as how to code linear search in Python based on pseudocode. First of all, let's talk about what is linear search. To find an item stored in an array, one method of searching is linear search. So how do you do linear search? Each element of the array is checked in order from the lower bound to upper bound until the item is found or the upper bound is reached. So let's look at what is the identifier table for this linear search. So first of all, we have this, which is the identifier column and the description column. So the first item will be item here, which is the integer to be found. It means that let's say I'm looking for the number 4 from this array, it means that the item is going to be 4. And next is going to be my list. So this array will contain some numbers so that the item can be searched. And next is going to be upper bound, which is the upper bound of the array. And next is going to be lower bound, which is the lower bound of the array. And then we have index, which is the pointer to the current array element, as well as found, which is a flag to show where an item has been found. Therefore, these are all the core identifiers for this linear search. So before we write the pseudocode, let's go through a demo example and a walkthrough first so that you can understand better. So let's look at this. First of all, I have my list array here, which is 27, 19, 36, 42, and etc. So this is the my list array, which contains a few numbers inside. And then I have index here, which starts from 0 all the way to 8 here. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next, I have lower bound, which is 27 or index 0 here, as well as upper bound, which is 55 or index 8 here. And next, we item, which is which number are we trying to search from this array itself. So this is the input number. So for example, let's go through with this 21 as the input item. So how do you search 21 from this array itself? So let's go through together. So first of all, we will always start from index 0 here, which is the first element of the array. So is 21 equal to 27? No, it's not. Then the index will plus 1 to this 1 here. And then next. Is 21 equal to 19? No, it's not. Then we move on. Is 21 equal to 36? No, then move on. 21 equal to 42? No, move on. Then 21 equal to 16? No, move on. Then is 21 equal to 89? No, move on. And once we reach index equal to 6, we realize that is 21 equal to 21? Yes, they are. So it means that we have found 21 in the array. We'll just exit the iteration and output item found. And next, let's go through this example whereby the number is not inside this array itself. For example, number 99 here. So let's go through together. 99 equal to 97? No. Move on, 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 move on. And at the last iteration, our index will increase by 1 as usual. So it's going to be 9 now. It means that we have exceeded the index of the array. Then we will just exit the iteration and output item not found. Therefore, this is how linear search works in general. It's actually pretty simple. What happens is that you're just trying to search a number from the array. If the number is not being found in the current index, you will just increase the index by 1 until you manage to find a number, or you just keep increasing until you reach the end of the array, and then you'll just exit the iteration. Alright, that's all for the demo. Let's go through the pseudocode itself. First of all, I have this sample array here with the index so that you can understand better when we go through the pseudocode. And now let's start with the first line. Declare my list array 0 to 8 of integer. It means that we are just creating an array with 9 elements inside. Definitely for this pseudocode sake, we'll just assume when we create this my list array, we'll just put some random numbers into the array. So this is the basic assumption that we make for this pseudocode. And next, declare lower bound as an integer data type. Declare upper bound as an integer data type. Declare index as an integer data type. Declare item as an integer data type. Declare found as a boolean. So definitely we have go through all these identifier or variables in the demo just now. Just scroll back the video if you forget what they are. And next, assign 8 to upper bound. It means that upper bound is 8. So if you look at this example here, this is the upper bound here. And next, lower bound is 0. So this is the index 0 here for 27. So lower bound is 0. And then we assign false to found variable. Why we do that is that initially we haven't found the number yet. Therefore, found is false. And then we assign lower bound to index, which means that index will start from 0 initially. And then output, please enter item to be found. It means that now the code is asking, hey, can you please give me a number so they can start searching from the array itself. And as usual, input item means that whatever that you type into the console based on that question, it will be stored into the variable item. And next, we'll start with our iteration. We'll be using repeat until loop for this use case. If item is equal to my list index, then it means, let's say you type in 27, it means that if 27 is equal to my list, the first element of this array, which is 27, then found is equal to true. It means that we'll update the found variable into true. Then we'll just end the if statement. What if the item that you type in is not being found in the first element of the array? No worries, we'll just do index is equal to index plus 1. It means that let's say you type in 36, it means that hey, 0 is 27, which is not equal to 36, so I will just index is equal to index plus 1. So I increase my index from 0 to 1. And now they'll try to compare 19 with 36. To end the iteration, we'll be writing until found is equal to true, which means that we have found the item, or index is more than upper bound. Means that we have searched through the whole array and we couldn't find the number, and then our index has exceeded 8 for this use case. It means that we actually searched from index 0 all the way to index 8 and we couldn't find the number. So we'll just exit the repeat loop. And finally, if found, definitely you can write if found equal to true, or you can just write if found. Because in coding or Pseudocode perspective, when you write if found, it actually means found equal to true. So let's say if found, then output item found. Or you can write if found equal to true, then output item found. It means the same thing. Else, output item not found. It means that let's say found is equal to true, I will just output item found. And let's say you finish running the loop and the found is not being updated from false to true, it means that it's still false. Else, output item not found. And finally, we'll just end the if statement. Therefore, this is the linear search pseudocode. Definitely, if this is your first time looking at all this complicated pseudocode, it might look a bit complicated at the first time, but no worries, just pause the video, go through the pseudocode line by line, and then try to do a walkthrough based on this example here. I'm pretty sure you can understand how it works after a while. Now we'll just go straight coding in Python so that you can watch a live demo. Alright, let's look at this. On the left will be the pseudocode that we have just gone through, and on the right will be my Python notebook, and let's go through together. So first of all, let's look at the pseudocode first. So for Python perspective, we actually do not have to define the variable, so I can just cross out all these pseudocode first. For example, this, because what happened in Python is that once you assign a value to the variable, they will know which data type it is. We will just keep all these 5 lines here. Definitely, we still have to declare the array because it means that I have to somehow declare an array with all these numbers inside. So I will just declare an array with all these numbers inside, and I will just keep these 5 lines here, and then I will just continue from here. So first of all, I will just create the array. So my list is equal to, I will just use this example, which is this array on the left here. So 27, 19, 36, 42, 16, 89, 21, 16, and 55. So this is how you can create an array using Python and next. So upper bound is equal to 8. So if you look at this, definitely there's some differences between the pseudocode and the code itself. For example, when I want to assign a value, I will just use equal in Python. But in the pseudocode, I'm using this arrow here. It doesn't really matter. It's just that there's some differences between pseudocode and the actual code itself. And let's continue here. So upper bound is equal to 8. And then lower bound is equal to 0. And then found is equal to false, and then index is equal to lower bound. Okay, so we have actually completed with all the assignments. So let's continue. Output, please enter item to be found. So instead of using output, I will just use like print. So print, please enter item to be found. And next will be input item. So to do that, I will just write like item is equal to input bracket. And definitely, since when I take in the input, the code might take in as a string. So I have to convert this string into integer. So what I do here is that I will just add int bracket in front and then close the bracket. So it means that whatever that I take in, I will just convert it into integer. And next will be the repeat until loop. Definitely to do this in Python, it might look a bit different. So I'll just skip one line so that it's easier to see. Wow, true. This means that while the loop is true, please continue to do whatever that's inside the loop. So wow, true. And then next I'll just write if item is equal my list index, and I have a colon here. So in Python, in order to do a comparison, we'll just use double equal here. So there is some difference between the pseudocode and the Python. So the pseudocode, we can just write single equal, but for the Python itself, I have to write double equal. So if item is equal to my list index, and then I will just update found is equal to true. So found is equal to true. So in the pseudocode, you have an if, but in Python, you don't have to write an if. So what you do here is that you can just go back one indentation. So look at this. What I do here is that I will just go back one indentation on my Python notebook. So let's look at this. And now this if and my indentation belongs to the same line, and then I will just write index is equal to index plus 1. Next, how do I write this statement here on the left here? So it's actually quite simple. So what I do here is that I can just come to here and then just come to here and write if found is equal to true or index is more than upper bound, and then I will just do break. It means that if found is equal to true or index is more than upper bound, I will just break this while loop here. Once you are done with the iteration pseudocode, we are just left with the output pseudocode. So how do you do that? It's actually quite simple. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to leave a blank line in between so that it's easier to see. So I'm just going to do an enter and enter again. Just do a backspace, backspace again. If file, and then I just write print item file. And then just do the backspace again, else print item not found. And yeah, that's all for the Python code. And now let's just run the code now. So I'm just going to click on run here. So if you see here, the console is asking you for the item to be found. So for example, let's say we input a value that is in the list. So for example, let's say I just choose like, I don't know, like just choose like 89. So just choose 89, it's good. 89, click enter. And yeah, there's some error here. No worries, it's just the name item is not defined. So let's look at this item here. Oh, I made a minor mistake here. It should be capital letter here. Always be careful of the casing here, whether it's a capital letter or small letter, because it does affect the code, as well as a pseudocode. We always stick with the right casing. So if item is equal to my list index, and yeah, I think that's the only error. So let's just run again. And then I will just input 89 again and click enter. And here you go, item found. And now let's try to input an item that's not in the list. So I'm just going to run the code. And now I'm just going to input 999. Because 999 is not inside the list, theoretically we should get item not found. And let's see. So I'm just going to click enter here. And yeah, here you go, item not found. Therefore, this is how you actually can code a Python solution for the pseudocode itself. It's actually quite doable once you know the syntax of Python and know how to convert the pseudocode to a Python solution. Definitely, if you're just taking paper 2 exam, you don't have to know how to convert the pseudocode to a Python solution, but it's always good to know and try. And once you try it out yourself, you should be able to remember this linear search pseudocode better. I hope you enjoyed this video on linear search pseudocode as well as how to convert pseudocode to a Python solution. Definitely give my video a thumbs up, leave your comment, and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.